Sunday, October 18th, 2020, 8:08, 8 something in the evening. Greetings from Knoxville, Tennessee. This will be my watch collection on a budget. So if you love watches, but you don't make a fortune, what does a watch collection look like? Several of these were gifts, and I will point those out, but most of them I have bought. So the first automatic I ever got, which is a lot of people's gateway, is the Seiko 5 SNK-803. Love this watch. I've got 6.5, 6 5/8 inch wrists, so I tend to prefer watches that are on the smaller size. So the 809, and this is the 803. This is on this strap, and of course that's on a leather one. I like that combination. So I'm a big fan of Seikos. If you know my German Shepherd, you know that I named her Seiko. So love those two field watches. This one was actually a Valentine gift from my wife one year. It is a quartz, but I think this might be the best looking watch that I have. And I'm sorry, I don't know the model number of most of these watches, but this is what I wore in my wedding, in my daughter's wedding. I love that. I think it's very elegant looking, very classy, great dress watch. This next one, I absolutely adore. You can tell that is small. I think that may be 34 millimeters. This is a Galet, and I've done some research. I don't know if this is from the 20s, 30s, 40s, or 50s, but a friend of mine bought this, had it serviced, cleaned up. It runs great, but his wrists were just much too large for it. So he knew that I've got tiny petite wrists, so that worked out in my favor, and he actually just gifted it to me. I'm not sure the worth on this. It's probably, goodness, several hundred dollars at least. But yeah, that is a diminutive watch, which is what they used to be. Love that one. Next, we come to my budget Casios. These, let's see. $12 or $14 there, I think $16. $16 for this one, I believe. This one has been discontinued, the F28W. I wish they still made this. This is just a no-frills watch. I love how it has the month and the date on that. Hey, this is so thin and light. It's a shame that they don't make this anymore. If you're looking for something similar, you're going to have to go with the classic F91W. Can't say enough good things about this. This actually has an alarm as well. Very similar to that, but if you want something on a metal bracelet. And once again, I do not remember the model number of this. This is very, very similar to the first watch I ever got. It was a Christmas gift back in 6th or 7th grade, so that would have been 1980 or 1981. A lot of nostalgia in this watch right here. Let's see, we'll move over to the Timex Marlin reissue. I think this is 36 millimeters, if I'm not mistaken. And this says circa 2017. I believe this has the Chinese seagull movement in it. This is not the automatic, this is just the mechanical, so it hand winds. But I'm a big, big, big fan of the Timex Marlins from back in the day, in the 60s. So, love this one. This was a Christmas gift last year from my wife and my in-laws. Very elegant dress watch here. We'll go up top. This is my most expensive watch. The, again, classic Seiko Diver, the SKX. It's the 175 in America, the 009 overseas, the Pepsi dial. This, if I didn't say, this was also a gift. And it just doesn't get, as far as dive watches go, it doesn't get any more classic than this. I think these, at the time, they discontinued these as well. But this was about $230, I think. Very comfortable. A little heavy and a little big for me. It's 40 or 42 millimeters, I think. Maybe 40. It doesn't look too bad on me. But I do prefer a smaller watch. But yeah, love that just for its history. Next, I have two of the Vostok Amphibians, or some say Amphibia. This one I bought new. It's the classic Scuba Dude. And I keep saying classic. I'm sorry about that if I'm repeating myself. Love this thing. It's cartoony and kooky and weird, but very, very substantial dive watch here. This is the real deal. I love these Russian watches. Used to have a Komandirsky, the field watch. Don't have one anymore. I need to get one. I also need to fix that band. Here's my other Amphibian. This was actually purchased by the same gentleman who bought and gave me that Galet. And he didn't care for it much, so I bought it off him for 50 bucks. You can see it's practically brand new. I think he only wore it for about 2 or 3 weeks. I like that. Those blue numbers are really cool. Another throwback watch. This is the Freestyle Shark, the 88. I don't know if they call it the classic or not, but I had one very similar to this back in 1988 that I bought in Los Angeles at one of the beaches in the surf shops. Mine was pink where this black is, and I bought a yellow band. If you were around in the 80s, you know that bright colors were all the rage. So this is just another nice nostalgia piece for me. And this water resistance to 300 feet. So that's, you can snorkel in this thing or swim all day long. Of course, a lot of surfers wore these. And finally, we have the G-Shock. If I had to get rid of every watch and keep one based on function alone, it would be the G-Shock. This will go down as deep as any of my divers. The face has everything you need, the month, the date, it's got an alarm, it's gonna take a beating, and even though it's a little chunky on me, this is the one I would keep if forced to. This will do absolutely everything you need a watch to do. And probably in the next year or so, I'm going to get the Tough Solar. I think that's what they call it. So far, this battery has not needed to be changed. I think I've had this for about a year. Batteries usually last, I think, between 3 and 5 years. I don't use the stopwatch or timer or alarm function very often on this. But I don't care for the Casio G-Shocks with the dials and the fancy stuff on them. Obviously, I'm a throwback 60s, 70s, 80s guy. So if I'm gonna have a G-Shock, it's gonna be this one or the one just like it with the solar battery in it. So that is a budget watch collection. Would I like an Omega or a Rolex? Well, sure I would. I'd also like a Tudor or any other number of high-end watches. But for my everyday life, I've got everything that I could want or need right here. Thanks for watching. As always, I appreciate the views and the comments. And you guys have a good start to your week tomorrow.